Rachael announced the news on Monday in a heart-wrenching tweet. She wrote, in the words of the legendary Frank S., I'm afraid the time has come, my friends. It's very surreal. Thank you so much for all the support I've received. I'm told I've only got days. And suddenly, Debs and Laz will continue with the Amoebic podcast. Au revoir, my friends. The 40-year-old mum had been documenting her battle against breast cancer in a podcast and blog series called Big C Little Me. Rachael lives in Cheshire with her husband of 6 years, Steve, and their 2-year-old son, Fred. She has been a BBC news presenter for more than 15 years. Thousands of listeners tuned into BBC Radio 5 Live each week to hear her talking about living with cancer with Lauren Mayen and Deborah James. On November 22, 2016, Rachael was diagnosed with primary triple-negative breast cancer that had spread to 4 lymph nodes under her right arm. She has been going through chemotherapy since her diagnosis in 2016, and spoke of feeling like a lab rat after starting a medical trial in a bid to buy a bit more time. After enduring months of treatment, she was told in May 2017 that the cancer was terminal. Rachael wrote on her blog about the moment she received the phone call that would deliver the news that her cancer was terminal. While with her son at an ice cream farm, my heart was racing as I answered it. Knowing a phone call did not bode well, she wrote. Then came the words, I'm so sorry, it's bad news. The biopsies have come back showing the same cancer is back and is in the skin. I watched my little Fred innocently playing away in a tire in the barn and my heart broke for him. I scooped him up and dashed home and then had to break her husband, Steve's heart with the news that my cancer was now metastatic and therefore incurable. Last month, Rachael gave a heartbreaking interview to The Telegraph. She said she is not scared of dying, but is worried about leaving her husband and son behind. She revealed how she had decided not to find out how long she has left to live, instead guesstimating that it was less than a year. I have to suppress a lot of the darkest thoughts about Fred growing up without his mommy around, she said. There has been an outpouring of support on social media since Rachael announced the devastating news that she only has days left. Fellow BBC journalist F. McGovern wrote, Rachael, I am so gutted for you and your family. The podcast has clearly helped so many people and you did it with such style, humor and bloody brilliance. Thank you for everything you have done. XX another BBC colleague, Eleanor Oldroyd, wrote, Dear Rachael, you have lived a life to inspire millions. Your many friends will be there for Steve and Fred. Love and peace and prayers from all of us XXX.